Very good morning, dear students. Today we are going to see about introduction to virtual instruments, virtual instrumentation. It's a part of the virtual instrumentation laboratory course. We are in the lecture 1 video. So the learning objectives or outcomes for this particular session is the learner will be able to understand what is a virtual instrument, what is the need for a virtual instrument. We'll be able to understand what is the evolution of virtual instruments, what is the different timeline, how the virtual instrumentation evolved. And you'll also be able to understand what is the difference between a traditional and virtual instruments. So this figure actually shows you, this slide actually shows you the concept of the traditional instruments. So we are all aware of, we will be using in our laboratory different instruments, say a CRO, a multimeter or a spectrum analyzer. We will be using different types of hardware. So all these type of hardware, what it does, you will be able to understand what it does. Basically it does one particular operation. For example, if you take a CRO, it does, we can view a signal, you can able to see output of a signal, you can give a triggering, you can observe the output. It is basically for viewing the signal. If you take a multimeter, what does a multimeter do? A multimeter is used to measure what is the voltage, what is the, you can use it for continuity testing. Similarly, you have a spectrum analyzer which will tell you what are the frequency component present in the signal. So all these traditional hardware system are made up of predefined hardware components. It has some predefined hardware. What are the hardware components that are present available inside this thing? Say a CRO. It has a microprocessor. It has a board. It has some ADC. It has some DAC. It has some channels. Predefined hardware component that are completely specific to their stimulus, analysis or measurement function. That is, whatever the manufacturer has designed it for, that is the only job the instrument will be doing. That is called as a traditional instrument. Whatever the manufacturer, suppose the CRO manufacturer has designed it for only for viewing the signal, then it can do only that particular function. That's the case of a traditional instrument. Now, if you happen to see this traditional instrument, you have 5 different instruments. You take a CRO, you take a spectrum analyzer, you have a multimeter. What they have in common, if you happen to see, it as a microcontroller, it has a ADC, DAC, all these components are common. So what people thought is, why not have this particular internal structure as common, as a shared resource, and develop different phases for the instrument. Instead of creating the real instruments, you have the same hardware as a shared resource. Using a software, you create a phase for the instrument. So using a software, you create a phase. If one phase is for, if created for a CRO, it functions as a CRO. If you create a phase as a spectrum analyzer, it will function as a spectrum analyzer. So the job will be simplified. You do not have separate instruments. Rather, you have the same piece of hardware. The phase for the instrument alone, you're going to change it. That phase is changed via the software. The phase is changed via software. It is equivalent to like this. Suppose you want a funny face, or I want to be order face. That really matters what is the type of mask you are going to wear. If you wear a funny mask, you look like a funny person. If you wear an order mask, you look like an order person. That's the same thing you are going to do with virtual instrument. Wherein you will have hardware is a common, the human being is same. But if you wear a multimeter face, it will work as a multimeter. If you wear a CRO face, it will work as a CRO. So this is called as virtual instrument. The instrument is having same hardware. The front panel or the instrument face is developed using a software. Why the face is developed using software? If you happen to see the evolution of the computers, so we have different processes. Day by day, the computing power of your desktop or your laptop is increasing day by day. So in earlier you have single core processors, Pentium P4, then you have dual core processor, then you have quad core processor, core to duo, then you have core i3, core i5, core i7. Day by day the processing computing nature is increasing. I still remember in my early days, a memory of 2 GB is a very big memory. Nowadays, even mobile phones are possessing 8 GB memory with 128 GB RAM. So the technology is growing very fast. The computing is growing very fast. A particular company called National Instruments, what they thought is, since this computing is growing day by day, why not use this computing power for measurement purpose? Why not use this computing power for measurement purpose? So they used the computers which were used day by day along with the measurement system. That becomes the evolution of virtual instrument. So virtual instrument is the use of customizable software and a modular measurement hardware. So hardware is your piece of hardware, that is, you have a microcontroller, you have input output channels, you have ADC, DAC, that is a hardware. Why it is called modular? Because it is shared. And you have a customizable software. Using a PC, you create a customizable software. So you create a user defined measurement system. So these are called as virtual instrument. You can see in the figure down, it has a software part as well as a hardware part. So if you happen to compare the traditional instrument with a virtual instrument architecture, both are having almost the same type of thing. It has a OS, it has a measurement system, but only thing, here the software is customizable. So you define the mask for that particular hardware. You define the mask. So whether you want it to be a funny mask or you want to become a horror mask, that is developed by a software. You have a VI, virtual instrumentation developed software. Using that, you create your software. You create your actual face for the instrument. You call that as a face for instrument. The instrument, as of only the hardware, you call it as a naked instrument. Once you develop a face for the instrument, it becomes a complete instrument. So at this point, we can identify the answers for these questions. What are virtual instrument? What are the two main components of a virtual instrument? Which company developed the concept of VIs? So you will be able to find the answers for this question and note it down. Okay. There are several platforms available for creating virtual instruments. The platform that we are going to deal first in this laboratory is LabVIEW. LabVIEW is developed by National Instruments. The expansion of LabVIEW is Laboratory Virtual Instrumentation Engineering Workbench. It is developed by National Instruments. So this is how a typical VI looks like. So in the next video, we'll see about how to open and how to work with basic VIs. Thank you.